Many web applications feature restricted areas accessible only after logging in. In order to properly scan such websites and web applications, we'll need to instruct the scanner on how to log into the application. You can either attempt to have Acunetix log in for you, which will work for most simple sites requiring just a username and password, or else you can create a login sequence. A login sequence works better for more complex login pages and provides much more control. Start by navigating to the login page on your site, enter your credentials, and log in to the restricted area. Whilst doing so, you will notice that your actions are being recorded. You can replay the login actions to make sure that the steps you have recorded are correct. The scanner will make use of the same login credentials during the scan. If the site makes use of a CAPTCHA or multi-factor authentication, you can mark the action as a manual action in order to complete login sequences that require manual input. Note that manual intervention can only be used with Acunetix on-premise when logged in on the same machine that Acunetix is installed on. Click Next when ready. You will now need to define any restrictions. Restrictions are buttons or hyperlinks which should not be followed during the scan, including logout links and any other functionality which we do not want the scanner to click on. In this case, we can go ahead and select the logout link since we do not want Acunetix to log itself out during the scan. The login sequence wizard will interpret an HTTP request and will ask to confirm the action to be restricted. Wildcards can also be used for session identifiers, CSRF tokens, nonces, and other one-time tokens. Choose to restrict the request and click Next. A login sequence on its own is not enough. The scanner needs to understand when it is logged in and when it is logged out, so that it can rerun the login sequence in the event of the authenticated session being destroyed. The login sequence recorder needs what is known as a session pattern. A session pattern is nothing more than something unique between a logged in and a logged out state of a web application. The login sequence recorder will detect this pattern automatically for you. However, you're free to customize this pattern if you wish to do so. Clicking Finish will ask you to save the login sequence you've just created. You can now upload the login sequence to the newly created target. Once you are done configuring the target, click Save to save your settings. That's all there is to creating a login sequence. Remember that more help is available at www.acunetix.com/support or via support@acunetix.com.